Welcome to Crypto West Coast, where we discuss everything crypto from a Canadian perspective. Today, I got a couple stories for you. But first, let's look at CoinGecko. The current total market cap is $1.8 trillion. And the Ethereum gas fee right now is 140 Gwei. I'll get back to that later. Our first story today is Visa is to integrate USDC stablecoins. On Monday, Visa announced that it would begin to use the Ethereum-based stablecoin, or the USD coin, to settle payments. It will pilot this program with cryptocurrency exchange crypto.com and then offer it to other platforms in the future. Crypto.com is accessible to Canadian customers as an exchange, and it offers a crypto-based credit card as well. This is positive news for people who do business in cryptocurrency, as it can lead to the bypassing of fiat on-ramps altogether. In case you were unaware, the Ethereum blockchain has seen an increase in use lately. This increase has pushed the gas fees on the Ethereum blockchain to prices of $60 to $100 at times just to push through a single transaction. You can view Ethereum gas fees right here on CoinGecko, and I like using this website to keep up on the latest prices of cryptocurrencies. And I'll leave the link below. Another website I like to use to check Ethereum gas prices is ethereumprice.org. As you can see, it has a graph right here of the current prices of the ETH gas, as well as a visual displayed right here. Another site I like to use, which shows the current state of the Ethereum and Bitcoin blockchain, is TX Street or Transaction Street. It shows transactions being loaded into buses, which are the new blocks on the blockchain. The buses have the average cost of the current fees to push through a transaction. As you can see, some transactions are being bumped off the buses if the person who is sending these transactions has not chosen to pay a fee that is the average price of the block being mined. If you are tax savvy enough and you know how to follow an Ethereum or Bitcoin transaction through such things as Etherscan, you can take that transaction and put it into this magnifying glass, and you'll actually follow your transaction as it makes its way onto these buses and eventually hopefully gets pushed through the blockchain. This news, however, was met with mixed emotions on Twitter. Some were happy to hear this if they had vested interest in Ethereum or the native token CRO of the crypto.com network, as they felt that their investments may increase in value. However, tweets like this one from Multigrain Bread states, "Sorry, but I have a strong feeling this project isn't going to survive. At some point, Visa will either terminate it or move it to different chains. The fact is, other chains are better equipped to handle this level of load. This plane will not work on ETH Layer 1 right now." Moving on to our second story of the day, the Oakland A's baseball team plans to hold Bitcoin obtained from ticket sales. This goes with the story I did the other day of Tesla holding on to Bitcoin when they sell their cars. This just goes to show there's another company that's willing to hang on to Bitcoin rather than sell them for fiat currencies. These companies are not going to spend the coins that they receive. They're going to hang on to them in their treasuries as they see value. This is bullish news for Bitcoin investors. It shows that these companies are willing to take Bitcoins off the hands of you and I. Well, two more stories in the cryptocurrency environment. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, share it, and hope to see you in the next one.